Hello guys, and welcome to the Outer Rim Smugglers Flight Academy. My name is Iggy.
And my name is Gary.
How are you doing, buddy?
I'm really well. Had a great day today.
Yeah.
And you?
Yep, had a good one. In this episode, we're going to be talking about hard turns on a large spaceship.
One of the potentially more difficult maneuvers in the X-Wing game, but also one of the most fun.
Yes, it is really rewarding to land a good move with the hard turns, I think.
Especially if you're going through some asteroids.
Yeah, or in between ships.
Mm.
In this one, we are going to show you some... we're going to use an interactive game we created for this purpose. And we explained it in episode 1. But we're going to play the clip from episode 1 here, and you can learn the game from that. So one of the interactive games is an obstacle game, interactive obstacle game we call it. And in those we're going to show you a couple of maneuvers, and you should judge if the maneuver lands or not. And then we are going to do a tips and tricks part in the middle, and then we're going to show you another series of maneuvers, and our hope is that you will do better in the second part where we have taught you a little tips and tricks. So Gary, can you tell us a bit more about this, how this is going to work?
Absolutely. This is one of my favorite games. This is one of the things I'm really excited about Outer Rim Smugglers Flight Academy. So you're going to see an image taken from Vassal. There's going to be a ship. There's going to be a dial. There's going to be an obstacle or two. Your challenge is to judge, is the ship going to be able to complete the maneuver without landing on the obstacle? There'll be a countdown timer. You can pause it if you need to. Take your time. So we're going to say, for here example, is this ship going to make this move? If you guess correctly, give yourself a point. If you were incorrect, you don't get a point. Count up your score and we'll see how we get on. So now that you guys know how to play the game, we're almost ready to have a go.
Yes, we're going to send you off to the challenge. So good luck and have fun.
Don't forget to keep your score.
So welcome back, guys. We hope you had fun in the first part. We're going to do a bit of tips and tricks in this middle part and then hope you will do better in the second part.
If you got 8 out of 8, then you can just skip this bit, go ahead to another challenge. But if you didn't get 8 out of 8, maybe this bit's for you.
Well, there's a chance that this will get you information, even if you get 8 of 8. So I encourage you to stay. So, let's start with
One hard turn.
Yeah. The first thing that we have to notice is the overlap on the corner.
Exactly. This is one of my favorite tips for a large base ship doing a one hard turn. It doesn't actually move forwards completely its own ship length. There's a slight overlap forwards and a slight overlap to the side.
This means that if a ship is parallel to yours, You can absolutely not do a one hard turn. It will not fit. And I think this, like Gary says, this is super valuable. This is one of the things that you have to learn if you're gonna get good at judging movements.
Exactly. So when you do a one turn, there's a slight overlap, but your ship is moving roughly the size of its base forward. So, which is the same as a two maneuver template. So forwards and to whichever side you're going, your ship is being transposed that far. One large ship base, two straight template.
It's like picking it up and moving it a base length forward and base length to the side.
Absolutely, that's exactly right.
Anything else on hard turns or do you, or one turns? Do you want to go to the 2 turns?
Yeah, let's do two turns.
So the thing with 2 turns is that you can, if you have a firing arc in a previous turn, you can measure the length and you will move the same as one range forward and one range to the side.
So this is one of those tips where you kind of need to prepare beforehand. Maybe in the previous shooting phase, you're measuring a target lock or you're measuring for who's in your arc, and you notice, oh, okay, this rock is just outside of range one for me. So if I do a two turn, I'll probably be safe.
So obviously you can't do this on the turn that you are on the turn that you are selecting your dial, but if you get a chance in a previous turn, then it can help you. Also, if you're good at judging range one, you should be good at doing hard two with a large spaceship.
Absolutely. Also, we said with the one hard turn, there's a slight overlap. With the two hard turn, the distance between the two ships is roughly half a one maneuver template or about 75% of a ship base.
Yes, I've put a maneuver template here, one maneuver, to show that the distance you will travel forwards on the inside is only about half a base size.
Half a base, exactly.
Are you good on the 2 turns, Gary?
Yep.
Okay, then let's do the 3 turns. 3 turns will travel forward about as much as a one forward with a large spaceship. That's the 3 template in both directions. So if I copy the ship and move it one forward or rotate it 90 degrees and do a one forward again, it will be in a similar position to the three hard turn. And so I think it's valuable to know that three forward template takes you just about as much forward in a forward motion and sideways motion.
I think as the maneuvers get larger, they can be more tricky to judge. So these kind of things are really helpful. Also, the distance between the two ships now, from being an overlap to being roughly half a base, is now roughly one and a half bases.
Yes. Like I'm showing here with one maneuver template to show that the forward motion on the inside is a little over a base. And all those things that will help you to judge better distances. So experienced players are not bumping as often as new players, but you, Gary, if you bump, is it or judge the distance incorrectly? Is it on the inside or the outside?
Sure, for me, it's very, very rare that I will misjudge the inside of a turn because the distances are much smaller. It's easier for me to see. If it's a one turn, I know almost exactly where the ship's going. If it's a two turn, I know pretty well. So if I do get it wrong, it's probably on a large move, like a three hard turn, and it's almost definitely going to be on the outside of the ship's turn.
So use the tools that we are giving you here, and obviously you don't get to put anything down, but it's easier to judge. For me at least, I think it's easier to judge three forward template than trying to see where the three turn template will end up.
Absolutely. One last tip from me, Siggy. If you remember that whenever the ships are moving in a hard turn, the ship is basically being transposed at a 45-degree angle. So here we can see a ghost of a one, two, and a three turn. And each time the ship is exactly still at a 45-degree angle from its original position. So I put these two range rulers on the side here so you can see. When you turn to the left or to the right, the ship moves always exactly in that at that 45-degree angle, and it's really valuable to know that. Also, you can see here that the maneuver templates, they don't really go very far outside of that area. So you can use that when you expect your maneuver template to go near asteroids and maybe your final position not to.
Yes, excellent advice. So this is the tips and tricks sections. We're going to send you back to the second part of the challenges, and we will see you at the end of the video.
Have a good go, guys. I hope you get a better score than you did last time. Okay, that's the end of the game. How did you guys do? Hopefully, you got a better score in the second round than the first. Siggy, how did you get on?
I got them all correct.
You got them all correct.
Yes, but I made the game, so I knew what it was doing.
Okay. Well, give yourself a pat on the back anyway.
Yeah, I'll do that.
And everybody else? We hope you did well. We'd really like to hear about your scores. Did you improve? Did you find any of the tips useful? Give us a post. Let us know. How did you get on?
Yeah, also, if you have any comments on the game, if you think it's good or bad and needs improvement, we'd like to hear that in the comments.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so this has been the show. My name is Siggy.
My name is Gary. We look forward to seeing you next time.
Yep, have a good one.
Bless, bless.